مولانا محمد الشيخ هشام رباني. نعره تكبير
الله اكبر،
نعره السلام
يا رسول الله،
نعره الحج
يا علي،
الشيخ هشام رباني
زنده باد،
جامع الكرم
زنده باد،
محمد زندار حسين
زنده باد،
زنده باد مولانا الشيخ
زنده باد.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
الملك حسين في مولانا الشيخ محمد بن دار حسين في جدة. That he allowed me here to stand up, although I am not worthy of that. I am worthy of sitting with the shoes. You know the shoes at the door? This is my place. Now the women are sitting there, so they are showing good humbleness. So if we have the men sitting there, it would be better the ladies come first and then men come second. But it's not the case like that in Islam. Because Allah honored the ladies, Allah want them to keep always being hiding their nice pictures, their beauty, in order to give it to their husbands and to the community and to the children. In any case, I would like to say that with great honor, I'm reading there, هو الحبيب الذي ترجى شفاعته لكل هول من الأهوال مقتحم. Means no one can take you except Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the one who al habib. He is the lover of Allah that will take you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we have to put in our heart and learn an example which just Sheikh our Francisci mentioned, that we are the West. We came to the West. We are in the West. Immediately jumped in my heart an inspiration. Oh, this is a big wisdom. I never thought about it. How we are the West. We are not the West. We are. But he said we are the West. Means there is, we are the West. Why? And this is a very notable thing that I never thought about it in my life except now. That Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alayhi afdal salatu wa sallam, when he established his state in Medina, he sent his Sahaba out. He didn't keep them in Medina. Although they were so thirsty and hungry to be always with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he said, go out, east, west, south, and north. And what happened? They were minority, they become majority. That wisdom that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't want to stay wherever he is. He wants Islam to flourish. He sent them out. As we came out here, he sent his Sahaba out. I visited one of his Sahaba and one of his cousins, Qusum ibn al-Abbas, buried in Samarkand, in Central Asia, near the border of China. He turned all Central Asia to Islam and he didn't know one word of the language of the people there. His presence was important to make a change. Your presence, your duty as youngsters is to make a change. Ladies and gentlemen, and to show the beauty of Islam. And the beauty of Islam is not in explaining some ahadith only and doing the prayers. The beauty of Islam is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is nothing else as a beauty in Islam other than Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everything else comes as dresses that Allah dressed him with. Allah revealed the Holy Quran to him because he was the beauty, he was the lover, he was Habib. Habib can get everything, but Khalil cannot get everything. You can say Muhammad is Habibullah, and you can say Allah Habibu Muhammad. You can say Ibrahim Khalilullah, but you cannot say Allah is Khalil Ibrahim. You cannot say Allah Khalilu Ibrahim. You can say the opposite, Ibrahim Khalilullah. But for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he is al-Habib, you can say Muhammad is Habibullah, and you can say Allahu Habibu Muhammad. So the beauty of Islam is the heart of Islam. And Yasin is the heart of Holy Quran. And Yasin is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Fatiha is the heart of Yasin. So Muslims, especially you, I'm not speaking about others. You with Maulana Sheikh Muhammad bin Dar Hussain Bir Sada, this giant scholar with his Shaykh, that they built all these places for Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, give them the honor that you will be in the future like them. They want you to be like them, although I know it's very difficult to be like them, but this is what they are looking forward. And if you find that in yourself, try to stand up and to spread the message of the beauty of Islam. And the beauty of Islam, as I said, is leadership. Because love creates within you leadership to be standing up, leading and guiding the ummah toward the love of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you are not going to be leaders, who's going to be listening to you? Islam will give you leadership. Tasawwuf will give you leadership. Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah will give you leadership. Why are they killing the Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah? Everywhere. Whenever they have power, look in Somalia what's happening, look in Pakistan what's happening, look in Afghanistan what's happening, look in Iraq what's happening. They took over all the Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani's masjid today, and his tomb, who is running it? Are the Wahhabis now? Not anymore Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. It's not anymore the Qadri group there. It's already the Wahhabi Salafi are running the masjid and running the tomb. If they were able, they would have taken the tomb of Sabah's army. Means, oh, you youngsters, we are old. We cannot give too much, but you can give too much. And I will tell you one thing before I leave, because I know time is very short. Keep this in your mind. Prophet ﷺ asked his Sahaba, they were sitting with him, like you are sitting now with the Shaykh. He asked them, many Muflis, an authentic hadith by Bukhari, who is the bankrupted? Who is the poor? Many Muflis. And as I ask you this same question, Mary Muflis, what you say? Who is the bankrupted? Who is the poor? What you say? You say the one that has no wealth. It's correct? Huh?
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Yes.
Mary Muflis, the one who has no money. And Prophet ﷺ said, no. That's not true. المفلس من لا عمل له. مفلس is the one that has no عمل. Do you have عمل? Do we have عمل? We don't know. Because why? What Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered said. They said to him, وَإِنْ صَامَ وَإِنْ صَلَّى. Because he's speaking to Muslims. He's speaking to his companions. And he asking them, who is the bankrupt? He said, the one who has no money. He said, no. The one who has no amal. And all of them sahaba. So why he has to tell them, who has no amal? Because then all of them, they pray and fast. They said to him, Ya Rasulullah, وَإِنْ صَامَ وَإِنْ صَلَّى. Even if he fast and pray. He said, even if he fast and pray. He said, وَإِنْ صَامَ وَإِنْ صَلَّى. لا عمل له. What's that mean? Means anyone who prays five prayers and might be before the imam will be in the masjid. He goes and backbite his brothers or his sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment will take his hasanat and give it to that one who he backbited. He would end up with nothing. O Muslims, don't try to backbite each other. Try to be united. You Ahlul Sunnah wa Jama'ah, if you are united, this big whale or this big monster outside is going to eat us. And we are, although we are majority, we are becoming minority. We don't have a voice. It's you that you will give the voice. Go and study in different specialties. Don't focus on one specialty. Different ways, different scholarships, different PhDs, different masters in different faculties. In order that you can help each other in different sciences and Islamic studies. Islamic studies is too much, too many different shu'ba, we call in Arabic, courses, specialize in different courses, don't specialize all of you the same. Don't be in the future all of you lawyers, don't be lawyers, doctors, professionals, engineers, businessmen, leadership, all of you in order to unite and keep relation with each other. If we don't do it now, coming a day that we will be lost. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preserving that deen. Don't worry about Islam. We have to worry about Muslims, how far they will deviate. Try to be loyal to the Shaykh, to this one who is running the school and opening his heart for all of you. And giving his time to make sure that you are studying well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all. May Allah bless you, but don't forget all the time to look at this where he says, هُوَ الْحَبِيبُ الَّذِي تُرْجَى شَفَاعَتُهُ. And correct the last word instead of مُقْتَحِمِي, مُقْتَحِمِي. It's ha instead of ha at the last letter. May Allah forgive us. May Allah bless Mawlana Sheikh Muhammad bin Dar Hussein Pirzada, and may Allah bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.